Hello and welcome to Indie News Fan Park. Indie News is the one-stop shop for India's super sports fans. I am Ankit Kedia and with me is Rohan Manglani. And today we are going to be introducing you to the managers of the ISL. As we are aware, a good league needs good managers. And this ISL season, we have plenty of them. Out of the 11 managers, 7 of them are from Spain. 3 of them from the United Kingdom and 1 from Romania. We are so glad to have these managers as their experience and ideas will only help grow Indian football. Rohan, what do you think about this?
Well, Ankit, you know us football fans and how much, you know, managers actually mean to us. I mean, for me, managers, it starts with a lot of fans start following clubs because of managers. For me, they are the biggest ambassadors of the clubs. And like you rightly said, you know, the values and principles, apart from the style of play that they instill in clubs, is something that lasts forever in the fans' hearts. So I think that you know, managers are so important. And like you said, you know, we are so lucky to have these 11 really good managers over here in the ISL helping develop this this country's football and bringing so much excitement to the ISL.
Absolutely, man. And let's begin with the first in the lot. It's none other than Stuart Baxter, who's managing Odisha FC. Started with him because he's the buzzurg of the manager of all of the list. 67 years old, the most experienced of the lot. He has managed the South African national team, who we know as
Bafana. Yeah.
He's managing the England under-19 team. One of the most distinguished managers. I think he's won about 11 trophies as a manager. This is his first season with Odisha FC. And I think Odisha FC has done a great job in signing him. Over to you, man.
Yeah, absolutely, man. And, you know, I'm going to talk about Juan Ferrando, who is the FC Goa manager. And there's so much that he brings right now to the squad. I already, you know, I've seen their 3 games which they've played. The passion he brings to the team, the style of play he brings to the team, his compactness, the way the midfield plays is so good, you know. And again, like you said, you know, he has that Spanish style in him. He reminds me a little bit about Mikel Arteta because of his age. He's not too young. He's only 39 years old. You know, he's also trained Cesc Fabregas and Robin Van Persie in his career before. And one of the key things about him is that he was a football player who got injured at the age of 18, and he was sidelined and told that he could never play football. So hence he's taken up to managing, you know, since he's 18. So that just defines so much about the personality. He's won the Moldovan Super Cup in 2013. He's won the Gamma Ethniki, which is a part of the Greek division. And he's also won the Football League in 2018-2019. So I think that Goa FC got a deal on their hands, and so have the players.
Interesting, man. I mean, you mentioned Mikel Arteta. I just hope that he kicks off his season a little better than Mikel Arteta right now.
Definitely.
But let's not go there. Moving forward, we're going to talk about Robbie Fowler, who's managing SC East Bengal. This man needs no introduction when we talk about his playing career. One of the most decorated players from the Premier League, and he's also considered a legend amongst the Liverpool fans. He is now obviously forayed into the management side of football. The first club, Rohan, I don't know if you know, he managed this club called Muang Thong United in Thailand, which was also the club he represented as a player. You know, and last year he managed this team in Australia called Brisbane Road. And now with SC East Bengal, I feel they've made a bold move of hiring someone who's just forayed into management. And SC East Bengal, being one of the most decorated clubs, I feel have taken a really bold step in hiring someone who lacks that kind of experience. But you never know. Yeah.
Well, I think that, you know, he's taken to managing only, you know, getting inspired from his very own Liverpool and what they've done over the last 2-3 seasons. Yep. Anyway, moving on to Saba Laslio, who's managing Chennai FC at the moment. He is one of the non-Spanish managers. He comes from Romania. He's 56 years old. He's won Manager of the Year in Hungary, and he's won Manager of the Year in Scotland. He was, you know, the experience which comes from the Scottish and the Hungarian sides definitely will definitely add to, you know, the ISL. And I think we can expect something different in terms of, you know, the other Spanish managers from Saba.
Fair enough, man. I mean, good to know. The style he bring on will be quite interesting to watch him play. Moving on, one of the most familiar faces for most of us Premier League fans over here, Mr. Owen Coyle, who is managing Jamshedpur FC. He's managed clubs like Burnley, Bolton Wanderers, Wigan Athletic, and he's also won the Premier League Manager of the Month twice. Yeah, he was actually last managing Chennai FC, which was last season, and he helped them reach the final. So he pretty much knows how to play in India, you know. And you never know, reaching the finals last season, maybe he's hungry. Let's see what he does this season with Jamshedpur FC. And I think they're in safe hands with him.
I think they have a challenge on their hands, absolutely. And yeah. Well, moving on to Manuel Marquez Roca, who's currently managing Hyderabad FC, another Spanish manager, 52 years of age, has no trophies, you know, in particular to show. But again, we've seen what he's, you know, he's capable of with Hyderabad. He's putting up a good show at the moment. And he also, you know, he replaced Alberto Roca, who joined as an assistant manager at Barcelona. So he comes in with massive experience, Ankit.
Okay, interesting.
Yeah.
Moving on, we go to Kibu Wichuna, a very experienced manager. During his career, I mean, he's had a pretty long career and he's managed mostly clubs in the top division of Poland. He's apparently trained Cesar Azpilicueta when he was the assistant manager at one of the La Liga clubs. And also, if you know, he's not new in India. This is not his first year in India. He was actually managing Mohun Bagan last season, with whom he won the I-League. So Kerala Blasters definitely have someone really good managing them.
Absolutely. I think that, you know, like I told you earlier also, I think that Kerala Blasters is one team which is doing so well with their possession play. So, you know, great job so far for him.
Yeah.
Well, moving on to Carl Quadrat, who is managing Bangalore FC, who's managing our Indian captain Sunil Chhetri, and who's managing one of our top coming Indian talents, Anirudh Thapa, at the moment. You know, he's a relatively new manager in this field. He's not really managed too many big clubs. Bangalore FC probably is his greatest challenge of his career so far. You know, he was the assistant coach who then, you know, has taken over now, you know, and become the permanent manager over here. And he's the only manager, and this is very key, he's the only manager in the ISL to always qualify for the playoffs. He's won one trophy. He's won it with Bangalore in 2018, 2019. He's 52 years old. I think there's a lot to come from him yet. And I think we're going to see that in Bangalore's next few games.
Interesting. Well, moving on, we talk about the Northeast United manager, Gerard Noose. You know, Rowan, I feel if Tom Cruise and Christian Bale had a baby, he would probably be Gerard Noose. Don't you think he looks like them a bit?
I absolutely think he was. In fact, in the game between Northeast and with Goa, we saw that Misty little bit. Between Northeast FC and Goa, we saw a little bit of his passion also on the pitch. And I think he'll be a great deal. But go on.
He's also the youngest manager in the league, being 35 years old. Believe it or not, he's 3 years older than you. And about 10 years older than me.
I like how you put it.
Pretty experienced, you know, this guy also. Although he's young, but he's still pretty experienced. He was the first team staff at Liverpool FC at the tender age of 22. Amongst the other club, he was also the assistant manager to Avram Grant, you know, with the Ghana national team. I think he's a great addition to ISL and to Northeast United. Young mind and yet heavily experienced. I think he should bring some great ideas to the table.
Absolutely. Absolutely, he will. You know, speaking about the next manager, Sergio Lobero, I mean, he needs no introduction. Assistant manager at Barcelona. you know, was also the manager of Goa FC, currently managing now the Mumbai City FC. One of the things he's really known for is attacking style of play. When he was managing Goa, they had the most chances created. They scored the most goals. So I think that he's, you know, he's one of those managers who's familiar with conditions in India. You know, he's 43 at the moment. He's, you know, he's taken Goa and he's won the Super Cup in 2019, which is very recent. So I think great signing for Mumbai City FC, you know, and especially with the transfer window they've had, he's probably going to get the right potential out from the players.
Yeah, and especially very excited to watch him, like they say, the new era under Sergio Lobera, you know.
Well,
let's see how that pans out. And I think finally, the most successful manager in the ISL. He's like the Fergie of ISL, you know. I mean, obviously ISL, it's not been that long yet, but he's won two trophies in the ISL, both with ATK Mohan Bagan. He's previously managed clubs, teams like the Bolivian national team, Valencia, amongst a few others. And what's interesting to note is that the Spaniard joined ATK in the inaugural season, and he won the inaugural trophy with ATK at that point. However, Lopez left ATK in 2016 for Pune City, but eventually returned to ATK in 2019 and he won the trophy with them. And hence, ATK Mohan Bagan are now the defending champions of the ISL. And let's see what he's going to do this season. Currently, I think they're in great form. They need to improve the game, but they're top of the table right now. Yeah,
absolutely. Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I complete, man. There's so much respect for him because, like you said, he was, you know, he was at ATK. Then he left. When he was at ATK, he won it. He left. He went to Pune. He came back to ATK Mohan Bagan, now in the ISL. You know, and last season when he was there again, he won the trophy again. So so absolutely, the phenomenal experience that comes with him and style of play.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we hope you enjoyed this Indie News Fan Park chat. Do let us know in the comments below about your favorite manager. Catch you soon on the next episode of the Indie News Fan Park. See you soon.